Hi there gamers. Today we're just going to be doing a quick video showing Suicide Squad on the Lenovo Legion Go. I'll show the settings and some of the gameplay. I'm early on in this game, so I've just gone through the sort of the first training session where you get to play as each of the characters. And I've chosen Deadeye, is it? I can't remember the name. And I'm going to be running through the campaign on this guy. What I'll do is I'll show you the settings that I'm using, because I think you're really going to have to play this at 800p. It's a very CPU intensive game. So I've also set my VRAM to be 4GB. I normally leave it as a default of 8GB, but it's very sort of RAM intensive as well. So I've set my VRAM down by 4GB to 4GB. So my settings. So borderless full screen, running at 1280 by 800. I think if you were to try and run it at 1200p, you're going to be dipping below 30 quite regularly. So I don't think it's worth running at that resolution. VSync turned off and targeting a frame rate of 60 frames per second. Where I currently am, it seems to be hitting that, but I'm pretty sure when I go outside and we've got more of a view distance, it's going to struggle with reaching 60. So I'm expecting mid to low 40s, but we'll see. FSR is set to quality. Preset, quality preset is low, shadows low. Texture quality is low, volumetric fog low, level of detail low, and I accidentally turned on ray tracing, so we don't want that. Don't need the FPS counter. And I have motion blur, bloom, chromatic aberration, and film grain all off. Having said that, at 800p, it still looks really good.
Quinn, be careful with that thing.
Can't hear you over out
here. With our combined strength,
that guy looks
we may
good.
Open this door.
Okay, so this shows as 59 frames, but it didn't feel that smooth.
Just checking. We're all seeing that thing, right? Cool, cool.
Has one-way ticket written all over it.
Voila! 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 Oh, wrong. Oi, Voila, what the hell have you sent us into? It's a bloody war zone out here. There's a giant skull in the sky.
Congratulations, Task Force X. You're the first assets to make it into Metropolis alive. We're sending a signal transponder to your location. Your orders are to activate that transponder. Waller out.
Give me one reason why we should go out into that shit show.
The bombs, dumbass.
Morbid curiosity.
Ah.
So there's just the odd little stutters while it's doing this cutscene. I'm hoping we don't get too many of them during gameplay. See, it's dropped to 17 frames per second there. And now it feels, I was about to say it feels alright. This is not good. Okay, looks like we'll get to see some combat, see how it performs then. I'm going to see if locking the frame rate will help at all. Although it sort of seems to be saying it's 59 to 60, I'm getting weird stutters. Actually, before I lock the frame rate, let's try giving it a little bit more power. So let's try 25 watts. If I can get, there we go. Okay, let's try that first.
Looks bad, feels worse, but once you
Charlie up with Brainiac. Ready to make the leap?
Lantern, I'm putting two rounds in this Brainiac skull. Then I'm coming for you.
Yeah? Maybe I'll tell him I only found three medics and one dead body.
So I would say 25 watts seems to be a bit better play-wise. So I don't think I'm going to fix the frame rate, I'll just leave it as is.
Alive. Captain Boomerang, you're on point. Recover the flash. Waller out.
Hear that? You lot better start calling me Captain Boomerang. Let's go. Gordon's gonna lead us right to him. If we go in the right direction. Just keep those numbers going down, and Speedy Boy's as good as ours.
Okay, I'm going to stop the video there.